Okay.
All right, so this is a space that you've probably seen, well, you've seen many times before, and you've probably seen every possible angle of it. But as you can see, it's looking a little more crowded. It's not full by any means, but you can see there's a ton of stuff going on, and this is usually how it looks when we're shooting videos. I've given tours of it before, but mini tour. There's desks all the way around the outside. This is my desk where I did my setup tour earlier this year. Gear closet. There's all the tiles we laid down and a ton of noise isolation, and we'll talk about that in a bit. Another desk, and then we have a bunch of the gear, some light stuff, some C-stands, some charging, and then some more video shooting areas over there. This is one of the three areas in this floor that we occupy. So this is what we call Studio A, and if I take you over to the other side now, you'll see Studios B and C. Okay, so this is B. And one of the reasons we have multiple spaces or just so much space is so that we don't have to lay things out over and over again. We can sort of leave things more permanently, and it makes the setup and making videos faster. I feel like I've shown the behind the scenes to so many people, but I haven't shown it to you like this yet. So this is the robot setup. It's very permanent. We don't move this around very much, but it's got the computer and the power supply, the robot itself, and the camera that's always attached to it. And then, of course, we light around this, and this is where we'll do all the robot shots. It's always in B. And over here on the other side, this is what we call the top-down set. I used to build this up every single time I wanted to do top-down shots back in A at the Dream Desk, but now we have a dedicated set just for it with a jib, a Kino Flow, this light setup, and it's very modular with all the top-down sets. And then over here, we just have a lot of props and things that we're able to also put in the top-down set. So this is B. We've done two spaces now. Now we'll go show you C. And so this is C. Easily the messiest of any of the spaces you've seen. There is stuff that we build in here, specific sets every single time. Now, the angles you see of it typically aren't messy. They're very clean, very organized, very intentional. There's some Easter eggs, there's some props. But behind the scenes, when we make those sets, the other half of the room is usually pretty cluttered. So that's why it looks like this. Bottom line is, We're filling up the spaces we've had for a little while now. And so our new plan is to consolidate everything into one incredible video studio. Let's go take a look at it. So this is it. This, and we'll back up a lot to see the whole thing, but this is the new space, and it's got big empty box syndrome. But if I pop up a floor plan of it right now, you'll be able to see there's a bunch of different rooms in here, and each one of them has sort of different sections. And so now when you zoom out and you see the way this looks, this is sort of the size of what A was. And if you turn around and look back down this hallway here, we've got all this room for activities, and I'm really excited about how much space we have. I guess let's just do a mini tour. So, okay, over here we've got that sort of main entrance area. Then we have two rooms in here. And if you follow me in here, I've done the beginnings of moving in, and this is still finishing up construction. So the echo is real, as you can tell, but this is sort of the general size of what B was and what C was. Every light is on a dimmer. They turn off. That's not something I could say about previous spaces. And also right now, every wall is white. So there's no customization or anything happening in here yet. But the goal is going to be to turn this into the ultimate video studio, video production space. And there's a lot that goes into that. But I'll continue the sort of mini tour. You've got color matched lights all up in the ceilings and sensors for when people come in here, and then here's a door to another one of the spaces that is also gonna be discreet. This I could imagine, oh my God, the echo is so real. But this I could imagine being a sort of a dedicated space just for B-roll where we can dress it up and make it look exactly how we want, kind of like how we have in C. And then we come out here and every one of these doors is a nice soft closing sliding door, which is pretty cool. And there's thermostats everywhere because there is HVAC systems all through the ceilings, but that's not as exciting. What does excite me though is the grid of metal bars in the ceiling that we could potentially use to hang things like lights and microphones. and power. Matter of fact, let me turn you around real quick. There is a drop down from the ceiling specifically for power. So that's a couple plugs right there. So if I happen to wanna put a desk or a robot or whatever we're doing right in this spot in the middle of the studio, we don't have to go all the way from the wall with the power. We can just come straight from the ceiling. So this is the middle part of the studio where we'll probably do some sort of carpeting or decoration. But the other thing about having polished cement floors is you can do a lot of smooth movement with things on wheels, and a lot of the equipment will be on wheels so it can move around between the spaces. Then over here, we have four smaller rooms that will each serve their own specific purpose. And they're not all fully decided yet. Things like paint and how much space is in them and what the lights do all have to be considered, but I imagine one of these will be just for the video gear. One of these will be just for the top-down set. So there's four of those smaller rooms. And again, over here, there's another one of these larger rooms. And the sort of vision I have for one of these is to be completely top-down lit. A lot of this stuff is gonna take months to build and plan just because we don't have the expertise needed to build that stuff, but let me show you what I mean. So there's already lights in here, but if we turn these off, you can imagine up above this, I've had plenty of opportunities to shoot in rooms like this, especially with cars, where you have basically a giant scrim in the roof and lights all above it shining down, and this huge soft top-down light setup can make things look really incredible. And then of course you can dress up the inside of the room however you want. And then other things like a psych wall and, you know, drop downs for different color backgrounds come to mind as far as things you can put in a room like this. But generally there's more space than what we have plans for, which is good. You get to grow into the space. That's what happened with A when I first moved in. One thing I do know what to do with though is this room, which this is going to be the Waveform Podcast Studio for sure. The Waveform Podcast up to this point has been audio only. And a lot of the stuff is months out in the future, but bringing the podcast table in here, having guests in here, and you can see I've started to soundproof these rooms one by one, but being able to actually have it a video podcast would be pretty sick too. So this is the beginning. This is the empty Waveform Podcast Studio for when that gets set up. I'm not even gonna show you inside the bathroom. I mean, it's a bathroom. What do you, it's tiles and stuff, I don't know. But having our own bathroom that we don't have to share with the rest of the building, that's pretty nice. So this is the kitchen area. A lot of people who saw these in the photos that I posted of it thought that they were debranded, but they're regular cabinets and we'll be able to put food up in here. A sink that I have to use for waterproof testing phones, but also, you know, other sink stuff. A fridge, a microwave, a dishwasher, kitchenette area. You could even probably put a stove in here if you wanted to. Also, one thing I really like about pretty much every one of these walls or windows is it's not just a clean white box. You have these character building steel beams and you can do things with that. And there's also shelves out here. You can put things on the shelves and there's just different decoration possibilities that we didn't have in this space. But the whole goal, like I said, is to consolidate everything into one place so we're not moving down the hall to bring a prop from one room to the other because we forgot it, and then the lens caps down the hall again. And we're eliminating all that. It's gonna be seamless. And I'm super open. If you know anyone, or if you're one of those people who have done video studio stuff before, reach out to me, get in touch on Twitter and in the comments about things that we can do with this space. Because like I said, the plans I have only fill about half of this space. And that's the most exciting part. So yeah, I guess this concludes part one. I'm super pumped to be moving in. I guess I'll end with a timetable. We could probably do two or three more videos. A lot of this stuff is just gonna be building out the studio, but you're still gonna see us doing videos in A, B, and C for the next couple months. We're still gonna be using those mainly. But as we start to buy and build in and furnish the things in this space, slowly we're gonna be able to start using it a little bit, maybe like 2 months. There will start to be videos in here, and eventually this will be the full-time space, probably before summer. So that's what I'm excited about. And until the next one, thanks for your advice and tips, and we'll be getting started furnishing. Thanks for watching. Catch you guys in the next one. Peace.